My new game's gonna be legendary. Even Griff Patch is gonna wanna play.
This is Andy. Andy has great ideas, but like many new scratchers, he keeps making little mistakes that are driving him crazy.
Here we go. Gentlemen, start your engine.
Super Street Racer.
Okay, here we go.
No, what the? Why is it? Why won't it?
No! This doesn't make any sense. The 1993 RX-7 has 280 horsepower and tops out at 170 miles per hour. Scratch just can't handle it.
I feel like I'm losing my mind.
If you show kids a white input box in Scratch and tell them they can enter any number in it, sooner or later some memer is going to type a million just to see what happens.
Epic space combat.
What the? No! Pushing the limits is a natural part of growing up, but it can really drain the joy out of playing games. There's no surer way to kill the fun in a game than by making your characters move too fast, jump too high, shoot too many lasers, or fight too many enemies at once. Great games are tested over and over again to make sure they're not too easy or not too hard. If you can't play your own game for more than a minute or two because you've amped up the variables too high, odds are nobody else is going to want to play it either.
Da-da! Da-da-da! Oh, stop it! Eat this! Piece of cake. Oh man, that was so epic! Let's watch again. No, that's upside down! What the? No! It's all wrong!
I feel like I'm losing my mind.
My Scratch students are always excited to show me their projects, but often they ask me to wait a minute while they move things around, show hidden sprites, and switch costumes and backgrounds back to their starting point. After years of playing video game consoles, where hitting a button resets everything back to the beginning, a lot of kids get the impression this should all happen automatically. That's not the way Scratch works. If you run a Scratch project and restart it, absolutely nothing will reset itself until you tell it to. If you moved your sprites, they'll stay at the wrong side of the screen. If you rotated them, they'll still be facing in the wrong direction.
Oh, come on!
If you switch costumes, they'll stay switched. If you change size, your sprites will be too small or too big.
Really?
If you hid them, they'll stay invisible.
Seriously, I wish this program was more hacker-friendly.
Every time you change something in Scratch, you need to go back to the beginning of your code and make sure your sprites and variables switch back to the default state they were in the first time you ran the project.
Oh, finally. Okay, so we're gonna need to widen this chassis out a little to fit that 1.3-liter twin-turbo engine. Let's do a quick reshape on this little beauty, and what? Why can't I? Where's the? What the?
I feel like I'm losing my mind.
If you open up a JPEG image in a program like Photoshop and zoom in, it doesn't take long before your image starts to look jagged and all kinds of hidden imperfections start to show. That usually doesn't happen the same way in Scratch, where you can dramatically resize your images without losing any detail or sharpness. Most Scratch sprites are built using an area of math called vectors. To draw this curved shape on the screen, Scratch only needs to keep track of four coordinate points, and the power of math does the rest. The great thing about vectors is they can be resized almost infinitely without losing any quality. Vectors work great for cartoon images like the ones in Scratch, but they don't work for photos. Images from the real world can't be represented just by using curves, which brings us to bitmaps. In a bitmap, an image is broken up into a series of tiny colored squares, sometimes millions of them. If there are lots of squares, things look fine. But the more you zoom, the bigger your squares get, and the fewer of them you can see on the screen. Use bitmaps badly and your projects will look awful, which is why it's so dangerous that there's a big blue button right at the bottom of the Scratch costume editor that instantly destroys your vectors and switches them to bitmaps. Yes, you can undo the mistake, but only if you catch it right away. If you make tweaks to a different costume and then return, you'll find the undo button is grayed out.
No!
Your image is ruined. You can no longer grab individual pieces and move them around, and there's no way to rescue it. In case you were thinking, I'll just switch back to vector mode, you're out of luck.
Ungroup! By the sword of Odin, ungroup!
There are times when bitmap mode is helpful, but a lot of new scratchers, like Andy, don't understand the difference and they keep making the same mistake. One other bitmap problem that often messes up new scratchers is images that have a white or checkerboard background. This is a really frustrating problem, but we've already made an entire video explaining how to solve it. You can check it out here. If you like what we do on this channel and want to help us find a bigger audience, please like and subscribe. We'd also love it if you share this video with a friend and tell us what you think in the comments.
These guys are so epic!